Hello, and thank you for purchasing the AirScape Whole House Fan. This video will walk you through the main aspects of this simple installation and provide you with a thorough understanding of what is necessary to put your AirScape to use. The main topics covered in this video include framing. A simple box will need to be constructed in your wall or ceiling to mount the fan. Wiring. This includes installing the wall-mounted switch and the optional remote control. And finally, the grill installation. Let's start with the framing. For this application, we've decided to install the fan in a convenient location just inside the attic entry. Once you've picked a location for your fan, go ahead and begin construction of your framing. Use the illustration in your installation manual to get an idea of what the framing should look like, and keep in mind that your wall or ceiling opening should be 14 1/2 inches by 22 1/2 inches. Remember that the AirScape fan requires at least 4 square feet of net-free venting area within the attic. The more the better when it comes to this. Consult the table in your installation manual for further information. Now, once you've carefully measured, cut, and constructed your framing, move it into the attic. Please note that for this project, we raised our framing to place the fan above the insulation. After you get your framing in place, be sure to measure and verify its dimensions. Our framing has an opening of 14 1/2 inches by 22 1/2 inches. Once the framing is in place, this would be a great time to mark and cut your grill opening. As you can see here, we've marked our grill opening at these 4 designated points using nails from the top. When you're ready, carefully cut out the grill opening and remove the drywall. This is what the hole should look like. Notice that it is within the framing we've constructed for our fan. Next, you want to install the included gasketing over the top of your framing. This will help minimize the little vibration created by the fan. As an important note, please be sure to remove the tie wraps that secure the damper doors, as leaving them on will certainly cause you problems. Next, get your fan inside the attic and secure the fan to the framing, making sure that you do not over-tighten the screws as it may affect the vibration isolation qualities of the gasketing. We also recommend that you thoroughly caulk all of your seams to ensure the unit only draws air from inside the house. Next, we move on to the wiring of our AirScape unit. Now, when it comes to wiring, we have a few simple notes for you to keep in mind. First, remember that local codes and standards must be followed in the installation of this unit. Also, a dedicated circuit for this unit is not required. However, the power requirements of 120 volts, 2 amps must be taken into account when allocating power from existing electrical circuits. Although a power cord is provided with the unit, you can hardwire it by simply removing it from the control box. And please, remember to turn off the appropriate circuit breakers before continuing to the next steps. We start by removing the faceplate of the unit-mounted control box. Please note that we've conducted our wiring outside of the attic for a clearer demonstration. First, we match up our red wire to the appropriate location on our control box, then the black, then our white. We then secure the wiring to the side of the control box. Here's a shot of the finished control box wiring. Please refer to your installation manual for a detailed diagram of this wiring. Now, just to recap, we connected our red wire first, then our black, then our white. Next, we have to connect the wiring from the control box to the wiring on our wall-mounted switch. Here are the two sets of wires side by side. Make sure to connect your wiring using a reliable method such as the wire nuts we've used here. At this point, you would mount your wall switch and verify that it functions properly. We then finish by putting the faceplate back on the unit-mounted control box. And we're all done. Now we are going to go through the process of wiring up the receiver for the optional remote control. This process is very similar to wiring up the wall-mounted switch with a few extra steps. We first start by removing the electrical knockout on the faceplate and installing the nylon insert. Then, we route the black and white power wires on the back of the module through the nylon insert. Next, position the module onto the faceplate and install the retaining bracket by sliding it over the module and pushing down on the bracket ends. We then connect the 120 volt power wires from the remote control receiver to the main power supply on the control box. First our white and then our black. Now, we have to connect our 24 volt wiring from the remote control receiver to the circuit board of the control box using a 3-wire cable. First, we connect our white wire, then our black, then both of our reds. We then finish by reinstalling our faceplate with the remote control receiver mounted on top. And we're done. At this point, remember to turn your breaker circuits back on and plug in the unit. If everything goes according to plan, your unit should power up and its damper doors should open. Success! For our final step, we move on to the grill installation. This part is fairly straightforward. Simply align your grill with the opening you've already created in the ceiling or wall. We then install the screws, making sure they enter the framing the unit is housed in and not just the sheetrock. And we're done. That concludes the installation video of the AirScape Whole House Fan. Once again, we thank you for your purchase of the AirScape, winner of the PCBC 2006 Cool Product Award.